a night talker. We're here for another episode of Night Talk with, of course, your host, Crystalline Fajas. Tonight, we have a special guest, Attorney Abigail Salaño, to talk about the employment termination in the Philippines. Magandang gabi, Attorney. Kamusta ka naman?
Mabuti naman, Miss Crystalline. First, let me thank you for having me tonight.
Thank you rin, Attorney, for accepting our invitation. We are glad to have you here and talk about our latest topic for tonight.
Yes, napaka-interesting ng topic natin ngayon.
Balita ko, naging HR specialist ka dati bago ka naging lawyer.
Yes, actually, I worked 3 years as an HR specialist bago ako pumasok sa law school.
That's a lot of hard work, Attorney. Well, let's dive into our topic, which is, what is the proper way of terminating an employee in a workplace?
Bago ang lahat, let me explain na may dalawang uri ng employment termination sa Pilipinas according to the labor code. First is the termination by employer. From the word itself, yung employer ang nag-terminate ng contract ng employee. Pangalawa ay ang voluntary resignation, kung saan ang employee mismo ang nag-i-initiate ng termination ng contract niya sa employer. However, before terminating the services of an employee, an employer shall observe procedural due process before terminating one's employment.
So ayun nga mga ka-night talker, it is necessary talaga dumaan sa due process ang termination ng isang employee. Di pwedeng kapag sinabihan ka ng employer mo na, "You're fired!" ay terminated ka na sa trabaho mo.
Yes, tama ka dyan, Miss Crystalline. Maaring kasuhan ng employer kapag hindi niya sinunod ang proper termination ng employee. It is against the law dahil may tinatawag tayong performance appraisal, which is a process of identifying, evaluating, and developing the work performance of employees. It helps the company to find out whether the employee is being productive or is a liability. Ito ay mahalaga sa HR management dahil it provides feedback to an employee's performance and can be a proof for the termination of employee.
Thank you so much, Attorney, for that brief explanation of performance appraisal. Mga ka-night talker, for the clarification and further explanation ng ating topic tonight, we provide a short scenario about the proper way to terminate employee through performance appraisal.
Please come in.
Good day, ma'am.
Good day, Mr. Jimenez. Have a seat.
Thank you po, ma'am.
Thank you for coming here, Mr. Jimenez. It was good to see you today. As what we have done last year, you are here because I'm going to discuss the result of your performance appraisal.
Okay po, ma'am.
I want to ask you, from the ratings of 1 to 10, 1 is the lowest and 10 is the highest. What is your own rating on your job performance?
Siguro po 6 or 7.
How do you say so?
Lately po kasi, medyo nahihirapan po ako sa trabaho ko, lalo na yung mag-focus. Wala naman po akong problema sa mga katrabaho ko. Siguro dahil na lang din po sa paghiwalay po namin ang asawa ko.
I'm sorry to hear that, Mr. Jimenez, but I think you are aware that personal issue must be separated from your work, right?
Yes po, ma'am.
Let me address this issue. Last year, we already gave you a chance to prove your competency in your job. However, you still got a lot of concern regarding your job performance. You've been frequently missing work, habitually late and unable to meet deadlines. The entire team is drastically affected by your poor performance and productivity. What can you say about this?
I'm really sorry, ma'am, for not doing my best in my job. I'm distracted lang po and dealing with some health-related issues. I'm also aware in my negligence at work, but I'm trying to keep up.
I see. Kaya nag-file ka ng sick leave mo twice.
Yes po, ma'am. So, I have time to rest and clear my mind from stress.
Okay. Another thing is, I check your employee records. And according to it, you've undergone multiple periodical counseling and process training. But your performance has not improved.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I will do my best na. Please give me another chance to prove myself at work. I won't be late anymore and I will try to meet the deadlines from now on.
I'm sorry, Mr. Jimenez, but we already gave you a chance. You failed to meet the company expectation and overlooks your responsibilities. The management have no choice but to terminate the company's contract with you. I'm sorry, Mr. Jimenez, but I hope you understand. We appreciate your contribution in our company. I wish you all the success for your next job.
I understand, ma'am. It's a pleasure to work with you. Thank you so much for giving me a chance.
You will receive a final paycheck after your last day with us. Please keep in the mind that there are documents that you have to sign. We will notify you about the termination process once it was done. Thank you so much.
And we're back, mga Kanay Talker. Thank you so much, Ms. Ganawan and Mr. Jimenez, for that wonderful performance. We heard the proper way to terminate employee through performance appraisal on a real-life situation. So, attorney, ito bang pinakitong scenario kanina ay legal?
Yes, Ms. Crystalline. According to the Article 282 of the Labor Code, an employer can terminate an employee for just causes, which could be any of the following: serious misconduct, willful disobedience, gross and habitual neglect by the employee of his duties, fraud or breach of trust, commission of a crime or offense against the employer, his family or representative, and other similar causes.
Nagpa-fall pala siya under the gross and habitual neglect by the employee of his duties.
Exactly. Malaki rin ang role ng performance appraisal para ma-determine ang productivity ng employee. Also, through briefing and review ay nagiging aware ang employee sa mga incompetencies or strengths niya.
Mga Kanay-talker, if you're an employee, perform your duty well.
Tama ka dyan. That is the main reason why the company hired you. Kasi they see something on you na alam nila na malaki ang magiging contribution mo para sa buong organization. Common sense lang din naman. Parang sa machine lang, kapag may sira at di na gumagana ang pyesa, anong gagawin mo? Siyempre, papalitan mo yung pyesang sira para mag-work ng maayos. Pero bago mo palitan, aalamin mo muna kung bakit ayaw gumana. Then, hahanap ka ng ibang alternative kung pwede pa rin gumana. Pero kapag hindi na talaga, you have to decide to get rid of it and find something better.
That really makes sense, attorney. Again, thank you so much sa pag-guest sa amin tonight, attorney.
Thank you also for having me. It's a great pleasure to be with you.
Sana naliwanagan kayo, mga Kanay Talker. See you again in our next episode.